agent struck on March the 14th, 2017. I think we're, a couple of months into the presidency? See if you can recall this text that you received. Finally, two pages away from finishing ATPM. Do you know the president resigns in the end? What is ATPM?
I believe it's a reference to the book, All the President's Men.
All right. Do you recall how you replied?
Generally, I feigned surprise and said something to the effect that we should be so lucky or fortunate.
No, it was lucky. Lucky in what way?
That he would resign as president.
You wanted him to resign 2 months into his presidency?
Sir, my sense was, in a personal belief, that I was not pleased with the direction and things that were being done with the presidency.
I thought you trusted the American people. I thought that was what you said in August of 2016, that the American people would stop him, and then they didn't stop him. And here
sir,
we
I
are
do,
in
I
March, all of a sudden,
people?
Not trusting the American people anymore.
Sir, what I utterly trust the American people. What I worry about is when the government of Russia puts their fingers on the scale and causes the will of the American people to be something other than America electing
that president. How many indictments have there been of Americans for collusion with Russia?
Sir, I couldn't answer that question.
Sure you could.
Well, when you
worked
say,
on the investigation.
When you say that, first, you know full well, sir, collusion is not a crime. I don't know where that term came from, but
well, you're right. It's not. It's not conspiracy, coordination, collusion. A lot of people use those words in the same way. How about we say conspiracy?
Sure.
How many Americans have been indicted for conspiring with Russia to impact the 2016 election?
None, to my knowledge.
Yet.
And we'll be happy to get Mr. Nadler as a witness at next week's hearing if he wants to help you answer that. So you wanted President Trump to resign 2 months into his presidency.
No, sir. I think I read that text as a snarky comment about a book that was being read and a comment made. It is a conversational text exchange. It is not a written expression of a desire for something to occur.
Maybe I missed it. Well, help me. God... that we should be so lucky.
Yes, sir. And I think you would accept as a very intelligent, sophisticated man that people frequently speak when they're texting or in conversation. You'll say things that are hyperbole or exaggerations or not literal because that's just the nature of the way
usually agent struck, not when I was supposed to be dispassionately, neutrally investigating someone. I actually did not. But let's go. We've already passed the who gives a F. One more AD versus an investigation leading to impeachment. And I think we've already established that there is a school of thought that you can be impeached even if you're not a current office holder. You can be barred from holding office in the future, but you did not engage in any impeachment analysis in your other 2016 investigation with Secretary Clinton. You saved all of that for candidate Trump. So I want to go to another text. You and I both know the odds are nothing. If I thought it was likely, I'd be there, no question. Now, this is the day after Mueller was appointed. When you said be there, are you talking about on his team?
Yes, sir.
I hesitate in part because of my gut sense and concern. There's no big there. So in addition to disappointing the hell out of my Democrat colleagues, that someone who was investigating Russian collusion didn't think there was any there, why would you be concerned? Why would you not be ecstatic that there was no collusion? Why the word concern?
Sir, I don't know what I meant. Concern to me seems like there is a lot going on and a lot presumptive that there may be something like impeachment. But, sir, you got to pick. Which one do you want? I'm either convinced that there's impeachment, I'm convinced what you just read, that there's no there. And the reality, sir, if you look at it, is the fact that I was looking at this with an open mind and saying, I don't know what
actually,
there is.
Agent Strzok, of all the universe of options, that's not the one I picked.
But
of all the universe of options, you looking at something with an open mind is not the one I picked.
But that's the obvious one to conclude from that email.
I'll tell you the one that I picked. The one I picked And it breaks my heart to say this about an agent for an agency that I have tremendous respect for. You as a counterintelligence officer had no interest in participating in a counterintelligence investigation that was not going to lead to impeachment.
No, sir.
That's how I read it.
Mr. Chairman, you are assuming someone else's position. Chairman, you're coming to conclusions on someone else's viewpoints in the hearing.
I'm pretty sure it's my time and the general aide's not recognized. I hesitate in part because of my gut sense and concern. There's no big there.
Sir, may I
respond? What were you concerned wasn't there?
Sir, my concern was not knowing, given these allegations, what existed. Whether on the one hand, there was no criminal activity whatsoever, towards the middle, that there were individuals kind of pursuing their own agendas for their own self-enrichment, or on the far end, that there might be an impeachable offense.
Why wouldn't you want to investigate it?
May I answer your question?
Well, my question is, why would you not want to investigate that?
Sir, I did want to investigate that. That is not what you're reading. What you are reading is my trying to decide what I want to do with the course of my career and whether to stay as a Deputy Assistant Director in the Counterintelligence Division, where I have oversight of a wide variety of threats around the globe, or whether I want to remove myself and go work on something in the Special Counsel's office that is very specific, that is going to take, I don't know how long it was going to take.
Yeah. Well,
you're leaving out one really important word,
Agent Strzok, impeachment.
Regular order. It's now a minute and a half over. Does it,
Mr.
Chairman,
if we may, that one word
on and on as long as
the quicker
you want.
I can go.
A
point of order.
I would take one big word of impeachment and add four big words of no big there. And the reality is, you know full well I said both, and you know why I said both. Why I did that and what I'm telling you under oath is that I did not know what existed. I had prejudged nothing. That was all to be determined. And that is a logical way for investigators, attorneys, and
everything
else to approach
with
an investigation.
The political death penalty and impeachment is not the logical way a neutral, dispassionate.
You know, point of order.
Chairman, we're demanding equal time for every member of this committee.
Mr. Chairman, and if you can't control yourself, how do you expect this committee to control itself? You've been out of control since you've been on this committee. Why don't you leave it alone? This is not Benghazi.
The general lady from New Jersey is recognized.
You're recognized, Congresswoman. You're recognized.
When she finishes.
Well, hallelujah. First of all, Mr. Strzok, I want to thank you for your service. Secondly, Mr. Strzok, I think you made a big mistake by putting those text messages on your your business phone, because then you opened up your personal phone, and here we are talking about this mess when it really isn't important. Because the other thing that I know, Mr. Strzok, is that even if you do have biases, you did not influence the outcome of this investigation. The IG found that the outcome of this investigation was predicated upon evidence and information. The other thing I know is that no matter how much you disliked Hillary and or Donald Trump, you didn't have anything to do with either one of them getting elected. You have nothing to do with the President of the United States disgracing this country every single solitary day when he embraces our enemies and sucks up. Embraces our enemies and is disrespectful to our allies. You have nothing to do with the fact that the President of the United States has declared higher tariffs in the name of security to this nation against our closest friend and neighbor, Canada, but no one on this side of the aisle has opened their mouth. You have had nothing to do with the president enriching himself with his emoluments and carving out opportunities for his daughter so that she's not negatively impacted with her brands in China. While this side of the aisle says nothing, you've had nothing to do with the fact that Puerto Rico is still underwater and without any kind of electricity in so many places. While this side of the aisle, that's a part of the Oversight Committee, has forgotten what its mission is. But nonetheless, you have been here and you have tried to answer their questions, and I have never seen my colleague so out of control, so angry, and so desperate to protect a president that we all know is not fit to be president. So I want to leave you this opportunity. Is there any question on the table, Mr. Strozak, that you've been asked that you'd like to clarify? Because I can give you 2 minutes and 25 seconds to have your say uninterrupted.
Congresswoman, I deeply appreciate that time. I do want, everybody's watching this and making up their own mind. And what I would tell you is, one, I'm sitting here telling you the truth. And two, independent of me, I cannot express to you my love of the FBI enough. The men and women who make up that workforce, their ethics, their integrity are unmatched anywhere in the world. And I think that's important, one, because it is who we are. Two, that none of them would accept any of the behaviors that are being alleged any more than I would accept it in him. And three, this entire exercise comes at a cost. We are doing things that are going to, in the future, tear down the underpinnings of what represent law and order in this country. And there is not a robust, thick wall there. I think people don't appreciate how tenuous the balance of the rule of law versus chaos is. And when we, as a people, engage in activity where we take institutions wholesale, whether it's the FBI or the U.S. intelligence community, and compare them to Nazis, we destroy things that, one, we may not see for years and years and years, and once we break those down, the amount of time it takes to fix is going to be tenfold. And I cannot stress enough that I ask all of you to take deeply your responsibility to maintain our system of
thank
government.
Thank you, Mr. Strozak. I just need to say in closing, if anybody should be pissed at the FBI because you all helped this unfit man become president of the United States by not revealing to the people that he was under investigation in his campaign, it should be me. They should be applauding you, kissing you, and giving you all awards, because but for you, we would have had a legitimate president elected. I yield back my time.